Then, gametogenesis, the formation of gametes from reproductive organs. Normally, meiosis cell division, one can take place for formation of gametes. But one thing one can remember, always gametes are employed in their condition. So generally, which one can involve in the production and formation of the meiosis? But in lower grade plants, like implantic plants, one can involve in mitotic cell division while formation of gametes. These particular that the formation of gametes are based on morphological as well as physiological, what I said earlier, just now, homo and hetero, here also in higher organisms, isogamy and heterogamy, oogamy, hologamy, that means the formation according to their particular size as well as their particular morphological features and that means isogametes, then anisogametes, then oogametes, the process we call as oogamy, then hologamy or hologametes. Isogametes normally we called as the planoflagellates or planoscope. That means which one can flagellate, more probably it will be motile in nature. The gametes normally motile in nature, isogametes, which one can normally observe in chlamydomonas. So both male and female gametes are similar, their morphological, that it is similar in that morphological, that physiological features similar. That is regarded as isogametes. Normally one can observe in chlamydomonas. Example, in chlamydomonas. Then microcystis. Apart from this one, microcystis. It is one type of the protozoan organism. Then anisogametes, which one can structurally same, but related to morphological, that physiologically it will be different. Anisogametes. This is, one can observe on chlamydomonas brunei. Chlamydomonas brunei, normally one can observe on anisogametes. Oogametes, that is we call as oogamy. So, larger size non-motile female gamete as well as smaller size motile male gamete. That is regarded as oogametes. Normally one can observe into the vulvax as well as the fucus as well as human being, such a type of higher organisms, one can observe oogametes in them. Like vulvax as well as fucus. Apart from this one, which one can be indicates in higher animals, including human beings. Human beings also comes under oogametes. Hologamy are macrogametes. These macrogametes, the organism itself acts as a gamete. This one can observe trichonympha, or type of the protistan organism. Trichonympha, it is one type of the protistan organism. In these different types of this, that gametes which one can be present. But in plants, most of the plants, the gametes are non-motile. But some of the gametes which one can motile, like once again observe carefully, bryophytes, pteridophytes, as well as some gymnosperms and brown algae fucus. These male gametes are antherozoites. These antherozoites are motile in nature. Normally, that plant male gametes are as well as female gametes are both are non-motile. But some exception like bryophytes as well as pteridophyte as well as some gymnospermic plants. Apart from this one, fucus like brown algae, the male gamete anthrozoites are motile nature. Remaining, that is a non-motile. Remaining all higher, like remaining like the dura, neem, all these organisms, which one can be not contagious. Then except that particular one. Then what from this one, male gametes are produced in bulk amount because of which one can fail to fusion with the female gamete now. When we compare with the female gametes now. Maximum number of the gametes are produced, that is the male gametes. So like that, gametes which one can the produce now. Then gamete transfer. The transfer of the gametes. So normally the gametes are transferred in lower grade plants like algae, such type of the aquatic organisms. The gametes which one can transfer, it will be required for water. Water is needed. Then what about higher organisms, higher plants? For the transfer of the gametes and all, it will be pollination. So with the pollen tube, the male gamete which one can transfer and fusion with the female gamete are presented. Then in higher animals, copulatory organ. In higher animals, copulatory organs are required. In the plants, normally that pollination with the help of pollinating agent like water, as well like wind, like animals, many different ways which one can be transparent. Then in higher animals, normally copulatory organ, which one can be present? Copulatory organ. It will be required for transferring of the gametes. So this proper transfer. But after transferring, it will be transferred into the female. Then now, what is meant by fertilization? What is meant by fertilization? Fertilization. That means fusion of the male and female. So like that gametes, which one can form with the help of this meiosis, cell division, except haploid the particular plant center. Then rest of higher organisms, the gametes which one can form from meiotic cells like meiocytic cells which one can be present diploid in condition, then it will be formed gametes under, that is that one can be present like apple, that regarding related butterfly, which one can be present, that all these it will be present, then diploid, then that gametes which one can be formed related to haploid condition. Then like that meiotic cells which one can be required, then half of that least number of that one haplopapus, which one can present least number, haplopapus one type of the plant, that is a 4 in number. You can remember like that E, F, that M, R, O, so this name of the organisms. Then I am going to write here only diploid condition, then one can remember, then oppositely haploid condition for easy remembering purpose. That A for apple. Then in a diploid condition of the meiocytic cells, that is in 34 meiocytic cell diploid condition. That B for in butterfly. Then that is 380. Then C for that cat, 38. That is dog, related to 78. E for that elephant, 56. F for fruit fly, which one can present number of chromosomes in meiocytic, that is 8 only. Then M for maize, which one can present 20 number. Then the rice plant 24, then rat 42, then onion 16. Some of the old textbooks, NCERT books, they are given myocytic cells 32. But according to new book, newly printed NCERT, that myocytic cells, that is 16 only. Then, but actually they printed, that is 32, not 32, actually 16. Then, ophioglossum. Maximum number of that particular chromosomes, which one can present. Then in potato, which one can be present 48. In human beings, that is 46 and all. Housefly, there is 12, but the least number of the particular chromosomes that are deployed, myocytic cells of the chromosomes, are that haplopappus. The least, what type of this plant? Haplopappus is the plant where one can be present the least number of the particular diploidic myocytic cell number of this one. Then maximum number, ophioglossum, is also a type of the fat, is also a type of the plant. This plant, it will be present this particular things. So this is diploid. Then oppositely, one can present, for example, in apple, the haploid, that is in gamete, which one can be present 17, like this. Half of its number, which one can be present, reduction number. That is, so gametes are always haploid male condition. Like this, the gametes, it will be formed under, the gametes which one can be developed, automatically it will be formed. Then, apart from this one, after, like this one can be formed in higher organisms, but some of the lower grade organisms, normally it will be involved in reduction division. Lower grade organisms, one can involve in mitotic cell division only. Through mitotic division only, from it will be divided. Why? Because haploidic cells, automate. Why? Because gametes always haploid condition. So, haploidic cells, compulsory one can divide mitotically. Then it will be formed into the gametes through mitotic. The fusion of male and female gametes outside the body surface, that is regarded as external fertilization. Normally one can observe in aquatic organism, either plants or animals. Plants like algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, such type of organisms, normally one can observe into the external fertilization only. Animals like amphibians, leeches, as well as fishes, which one can take place? External one. It will be takes place. In plants like algae and bryophytes and pteridophytes, normally one can involve in external fertilization. Internal fertilization, all higher animals as well as plants, apart from this one, in higher plants like gymnosperms as well as angiosperms, higher plants like gymnosperms, angiosperms, that fusion of male gamete with the female gamete, that is we called as internal. That one can take place in internal fertilization, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Then, some of the organisms within the same body, where one can involve in the fusion of male and female gamete. That is we called as homotheny, or we called as self-fertilization. Homo, that which one can represent homothely, or otherwise we call it as self-fertilization within the same organism. The fusion of male and female gamete takes place within the same organism. It is external, based on environment. Inside the female reproductive tract, we call it as internal fertilization. Outside the body, we call it as external fertilization. Within the female reproductive tract, the fusion of male and female gamete, that is regarded as self-fertilization. It will be very rarely what can take place in particular organisms like a tapeworm. Self-fertilization, one can observe in tapeworm. Then, cross-fertilization. Cross-fertilization, normally one can take place inside the female reproductive tract. That is regarded as cross-fertilization. Inside the female reproductive tract. Here, self-fertilization within single organism, both male and female gametes are fusion. Cross-fertilization, that is normally one can observe only in unisexual organisms. So, one organism, another organism, male organism, one can produce male gametes under which one can transfer and fusion of female gametes inside the female reproductive tract. That is regarded as cross-fertilization. That normally unisexual organisms. Unisexual organisms commonly one can observe cross-fertilization either plants as well as animals, normal organisms. Then after the fusion of gametes, normally one can involve zygote. Normally gametes are haploid condition, then fusion of gametes, then it will be formed with a zygote. Zygote, it is a diploid in condition. Then, in lower grade organisms, this zygote further unable to continue on. The development of or dividing of zygote and all, it will be time will be takes place. That means, in unfavorable conditions, sexual reproduction takes place in lower grade organisms. Like, one can form the surrounding of the zygote, a thick cell wall one can form. That is regarded as zygospore. Zygospore, which normally one can observe regarding related to in that protista as well as some earlier algae, protista as well as algae. Then protista as well as algae, the zygospores are present. These zygospores temporarily unable to divide, then which one can undergo resting position. Why? Because it is unfavorable condition, like protista as well as oleander. Whenever favorable condition ready to produce, then one can formation of haplotic. Haplotic, that means that particular organism. Normally, these one can observe haplotic life cycle. Why? Because in plants, haplotic life cycle. Normally, haplotic life cycle like algae, like protista, which one can involve in such type of zygospore. Remaining higher organisms, the zygote, which one can undergo. But here, zygospore undergoes meiosis. One can form that sporophytic cell, haplotic sporophyte, haplotic particular parts which one can form. So, zygospore undergoes meiosis, one can form haploid. So, this is only rare. Zygospore, which one can cover the cell wall under, which one can resting under. Whenever favorable condition, again, mitotic cell division, then one can be developed as a complete organism. Then, in higher organisms, both plants as well as animals, which undergoes mitotic cell division under formation of embryo, which undergoes mitosis. So that is important. It is mitosis, this is meiosis. Then one can develop into the embryo. Then such type of development of embryo we call it as embryogenesis. The development of this one normally we call it as embryogenesis. In this, while developing of embryo related to in particular animals, development of embryo related to animals, and there are different types of the animals. That is regarded as oviparous organisms as well as viviparous organism, then ovo viviparous organism. That is, everybody know very, very simple and basic thing under viviparous, the organism which one can lay eggs. More probably in lower grade organisms like animals, it is related to animals. So depends upon development of embryo, the animals. Normally, viviparous higher organisms like birds and reptiles, very thick calcareous shell, it will be laying under. That is, we call it as viviparous. Normally, apart from vertebrate, like reptiles, as well as birds, thick calcareous. Then apart from these ones, some fishes also it will be present, but more common. Then viviparous, then vertebrate like annelid organisms, then viviparous, which one can give egg ones directly. Such type of organisms we call as viviparous. Viviparous organism more probably that the mammals it will be present. Then ovoviviparous, this is very important. Ovoviviparous means these animals one can lay eggs inside the female reproductive tract, but unable to nourishing the food material from parent to the embryo, unable to produce because of placenta will be absent. Why? Because here eutherian organisms means which one can possess a specific placenta connected from mother to the egg one, which one can supply to the food material. But here these organisms, placenta will be absent, even though one can produce the egg cylinder, then one can hatching. After hatching that particular eggs, then which one can give birth to the egg ones. That's why O means one can lay eggs inside the female reproductive, not external. Then viviparous means one can give birth directly. Then normally one can observe rattlesnake as well as a shark. So this is important. Then lower grade organisms like Eukarya, a type of parasitic nematode parasite, also oviparous. Apart from that particular plants, after fertilization, some of these particular, suppose in a flower like a calyx, corolla, as well as andrecium, perineum, that particular parts are present. Everybody knows that the calyx, as well as corolla, as well as andrecium, all these parts are grouping off after fertilization. Which one can persist only ovary? After fertilization, that growth and development, all these which one can involve in after fertilization, one can observe this development of this one. Those are post fertilization events. Post fertilization. In that post fertilization events, that oviparous, viviparous, oviparous, apart from in that plants, after fertilization, that the zygote converts into the embryo, then one can grouping of calyx, corolla. Then here, that ovary, it converts into the fruit. Ovary converts into the fruit. Ovule converts into the seed. Ovule, it converts into the seed. Then, apart from this one, this particular rest of this ovary, that ovule, that membrane of the ovule, it converts into the pericarpus. Pericarp, the central point, that is the placenta, everything it will be presented. So in this post-fertilization events, remaining part, ovule, style, stigma, every part. Then another very important, which part, calyx are persistent even after fertilization, like the China rose, like brinjal, like a tomato. So tomato, brinjal, China rose, even after fertilization, the calyx are persistent. That means the sepals. That means the sepals are persistent. Rest of remaining all organisms, it will be drooping off. It will be withering away. But this organism, it will be retaining as usual. Then, apart from this one, one can observe this parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis. This is, in this parthenogenesis, that means without fusion, of the gametes, formation of the gametes. So last class only briefly we discussed there is a parthenogenesis. It is many times they ask in exam point of view. That's why few more, one or two points one can discuss there. Parthenogenesis without fusion of the gametes and in this parthenogenesis, normally one can observe into the animals as well as higher that particular animals, very less in number, lower grade like the insects, arthropod organisms, maximum one can take place in parthenogenesis. But what is the difference between parthenogenesis and parthenocarpy? Then apomixis. Parthenogenesis without fusion of gametes, formation of complete organism. Here, formation of fruit without fusion of gametes. It is formation of egg ones. Here, formation of fruit without fusion of gametes. That means seedless fruit. It represents seedless fruit. Then, apomixis. Apomixis, there is no formation and fusion of gametes. But here, parthenogenesis, the female gamete one can produce, one can, without fusion, one can produce. Here, gametes are formed. Here, without formation and fusion of gametes and development of complete organism, that is required. So, both parthenogenesis as well as parthenogenesis, apomixis, morphologically, that genetically, similar, the particular egg ones are formed. Whereas sexual mode of reproduction, genetically variation. That's why it is helpful for evolution of the species and all. Then, in that parthenogenesis, apart from some extra points, that is Arginotoki, Thelitoki, as well as Amphitoki. Arginotoki, as well as Thelitoki, and Amphitoki. Arginotoki, from female gamete, which one can produce only male organisms, unfertilized male organisms. That is, male organisms are only one can form. So, here in that particular gamete, one can produce only male organisms. Male organisms, for example, like arthropod organisms, like wasp, as well as such type of these arthropod organisms are more importantly only observable, as well as honeybees, as well as wasps, as well as aphids, which one can be present in Arginotoki. So once again, the honeybees, especially male honeybees, unfertilized. In honeybee, queen honeybee is there, worker honeybees are there. But here very important, queen honeybee. Then Thelitoki, that particular gamete which one can undergoes, then one can formation of female organisms. Here, in higher organisms like reptiles, which one can be present, that particular, in that Thelitoki, that Typhlina, one type of the snake, then which one can be present, one type of this reptile organism, which one can undergoes one in formation of only female organism. Then Amphitoki, either male or female organism. So Amphitoki means in that gamete, either male organism or female organism. That is example, aphids and all. More commonly, one can observe the parthenogenesis, apart from this one, the turkey birds also rarely one can observe in the turkey birds. That is, then apart from this one, some diagrammatically which one can give in our book, that is repeatedly which one can ask that question center. Then related to Kara, what type of organism related to reproductively, either monoecious or dioecious, it is one type of the monoecious one. That means both male and female, but very, very important, which part of that particular area that monoecious, that means male and female parts are present, normally undifferentiated. It will be present like this manner. This particular part which one can expand, that will be like this present. But in this diagrammatically, many number of times repeatedly they ask me, which particular reproductive part present upper part of this one? That is oogonium. Upper part is the oogonium. Then, what is the lower part? Antheridium. That is important. Antheridium. So, any one part one can remember, either upper and lower. Apart from this one, so different arrangement of that respectable of this after post-fertilization of the some particular angiospermic plant center. This one, this is the seed, this is the pericarpellum. So this is the seed, this is the pericarp. S represents seed, P represent pericarp. So these are seed, this is the pericarp. Here, S represents seed, P represents pericarp. In this, the first one, it represents, that is the bean. They did not give the name of that particular one, but you must remember, this, that is the bean. Then, the particular, this one, tomato. Tomato. Which one can represent that particular? Tomato. Then, remaining that particular part, the third diagrammatically, which one can represent it? That is the mustard one. This is that mustard seed and all. This is the cucumber. This is cucumber. So like that, one can go through almost all these one, apart from this one, that one more diagrammatic representation, like Markansia. These rough diagrams. Markansia, here only the complex structures, that is the Jamma cups also it will be present, that is asexual mode of reproduction. So like this flower-like structure we called as archegoniophore. That is the female part. Archegoniophore. Wherever this one, Antheridiophore. That is, which one can represent? The male thallus. This is the male thallus. This is the female thallus. So, many diagrams one can given, but repeatedly, earlier, which one can be asked? Particular Markansia, that particular kala, on which one can arrangement of that particular seeds inside that particular ovary arrangement. That is which one can. Apart from this one, that recently, that last year, that one among these polycarpic, that particular plant, which one can be flowering, that is a Strobilanthus cuthianum, once in a 12 years, that September, October. It is, why? Because it will be present in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Islo region, blue color one, once in a year, last September to October 2018, which one can be blooming. That is also one can be remember and carefully. So, once again, go through all these one, this is only fundamental center, and deeply, once again, we will give the respectable of assignments, then you can solve, is there any remaining? The previous year asking questions under that next one we must discuss that particular these particular things remaining parts under. Then apart from these fundamentals, then the forthcoming chapters still detailedly which one can discuss and explain very clear, because of this is little bit when you compare to remaining chapters, this is the first chapter which one can limited less weightage marks under. But even though other than NCRT, one can go through. Because of this year only, one can merge it, JIPMER as well as AIIMS. There is no separate exams. Within NEET exam only, one can ready to write it. Then in extra points, once again go through the MCRT, which one can upload one that particular assignment and practice. Okay, thank you.